We have a big weekend coming up this weekend in Salisbury, Connecticut, and that is, of course, Jump Fest 2019, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday, Friday Night Lights, plus the Human Dog Sled Race. Saturday brings us ski jumping and also the snowball, and then Sunday brings us ski jumping. And it's a great weekend, and more information is available at jumpfest.org. Coming up the weekend of February 23rd and 24th, it is a weekend of wintertime activities in Norfolk, a weekend in Norfolk, winter edition. And with us this morning to give us a little insight in that is Ryan Craig. Ryan, good morning. Thanks for joining us.
Good morning. How are you?
Good. So now, how do you represent the weekend in Norfolk, Ryan? Are you on one of the organizing committees?
I think the great thing about Weekend in Norfolk is that everyone in town is kind of a part of that organizing committee. Weekend in Norfolk is all about getting together as a community and putting up a good time for people to come and see what Norfolk has to offer, just all the different things that make Norfolk what it is, a unique and different space, and to get people out of the house in a season that otherwise wouldn't necessarily come out to just see the cold weather, have a bunch of activities to make it a fun weekend and make, you know, for some memories here in the northwest corner.
All right, what business do you own, Ryan?
So I own the Berkshire Country Store in Norfolk. We've been here for a little over 2 years.
Congratulations. You've done a hell of a job relocating that store to Norfolk, and you really have become a hub there.
Yeah. I mean, I think that was the initial thought, was to try to bring community back to the downtown, lacking a store before our arrival, left a kind of a void of place to meet for coffee or grab a bite to eat in the downtown at lunchtime. So we, I think we fulfilled that role pretty nicely.
And being the center of attention, I mean, it must be nice being where you are, because you're in close proximity to infinity, but you're also you're an easy walk to anybody who's in that downtown area.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, it kind of changes the walkability of the downtown to be able to walk into town and get a gallon of milk or have some, you know, some breakfast, like I mentioned. So, you know, that's, otherwise you're driving 20 minutes to either town on either end, whether it be Canaan or Winsted, and trying to get the necessities. So I think it kind of changes the dynamics of the town quite nicely.
We are speaking with Ryan Craig from Berkshire Country Store, but we're talking about winter weekend in Norfolk, which comes up actually pretty quickly, February 23rd and 24th. By the way, great website, weekendinnorfolk.org. Weekendinnorfolk.org is where you will find everything listed, both indoor and outdoor. And the great thing about Norfolk and all the events that, I mean, there are just too many events, really. But you've got the Norfolk Curling Club there, who's been having bond spiels. And Ryan, one of the great things about them is that people can go to the curling club and watch curling for free in a real nice, warm, heated environment.
Yeah, I think the misconception is, like, going to a hockey game, you got to bundle up. But their facility up there is all brand new and state-of-the-art. It's got a whole warm exterior if you're not the type that wants to get out and curl. And they've been known to show a few people how to curl on their own just on the fly if you ask politely. So it's one of those things that I think is underutilized. It's hidden up here in the northwest corner, but not every town has a curling club. And I think that's definitely one thing that Norfolk is proud of.
Well, they're having an open house, so you folks are going to get a good chance to see that. That's at 70 Golf Drive. Also, a puppet show is happening at the Norfolk Library on the first day at 10 o'clock. There's going to be a farmer's market, which is just right up from you at Town Hall. Probably one of the best indoor farmer's markets that's around in the area.
Yeah, I would absolutely agree. You know, to be able to put together a group that comes out not only in the summer when veggies are sharp, fresh, and new, but to be able to bring enough product in the winter months and then supply a program like that is no short of a lot of work. So these guys do a great job coming out and making that happen. And Weekend in Norfolk will just be one more reason to come visit the farmers market.
All right, then, on that opening, I mean, it's just, I mean, literally, folks, there's probably 50 things to do indoors and outdoors on Norfolk on the first day. But it wraps up with a real nice concert at Infinity Hall, as a matter of fact. Doobie Others, which is, of course, a great Doobie Brothers show, which is one of the best Doobie Brothers shows I think I've seen in a long, long time. So that, I mean, the first day really basically goes with different events from early in the morning till late at night, and then Sunday is the same way, where you've got town skating at the rink. The Norfolk Curling Club has their open house once again. A Battelle Chapel once again has stained glass window tours going on. The outdoors, the Great Mountain Forest. You've got the Open Sugar House on Saturday. You've got art shows. You've got artisan demos. And then a murder mystery evening on Sunday night at the Manor House Inn. So, I mean, really a lot of different events to cover a lot of different things.
Absolutely. I think it'll be a good time for the whole family.
All right. And once again, people can get more information at weekendinnorfolk.org, weekendinnorfolk.org. So now I have to get, before I let you go here, right, I have to ask you, from when you opened the store to now, have things gone at the Berkshire Country Store like you thought, or has it been a little bit different?
Have they been as I thought they would be?
Yeah, or else is it different, or is there anything different about how you've grown and how things have happened?
Well, I think the main difference is certainly in contrast from our prior location in Cornwall is that now we've become the center of town. Before we were seeing traffic that was passerby traffic, and here in Norfolk we're at the heart of the downtown, and so it's not uncommon for someone to come in and order breakfast, run up to the bank, make a deposit, grab your mail, and meet back here for, you know, a 9 a.m. with a friend and having a cup of coffee and sharing good times. And I think that is what's changed the downtown, I think, bumping into people that you wouldn't otherwise see. I see a lot of that over the counter where people say, oh, I haven't seen you in 3 years. How are you? And I think without the Berkshire Country Store, that's one last opportunity to bump into a friend just kind of unknowingly. So, it's definitely changed things, and I think it's exactly what we wanted when we came.
Now, do you have a Facebook page or a web page?
Yes, we do. Our website is www.berkshirecountry.com. Our Facebook page is also Berkshire Country Store. We have a lot of activity going on there. Try to keep it fun and entertain some folks. So love for everybody to go over and check it out.
All right. Weekend in Norfolk, February 23rd and 24th. Ryan, thank you very much for joining us, and have a great day.
I thank you. Take care.
All right. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
That is it. There you see it. A Weekend in Norfolk, the winter version of the Weekend in Norfolk, the 23rd and 24th. Once again, weekendinnorfolk.org is the website for more information.